Today, I'm going to discuss about one more important property of cut sets, that is the ring sum of two cut sets. Theorem says ring sum of any two cut sets in a graph is either a third cut set or an edge disjoint union of cut sets. So let G be a graph and S1 and S2 are two cut sets. We know that cut set will partition the vertex set of a graph. So cut set S1 will partition the vertex set into two, that is V1 and V2, and cut set S2 will partition the vertex set into V3 and V4, such that we know V1 union V2 is nothing but set of all vertices of graph G, and their intersection is empty. Similarly, here cut set S2 will partition the vertex set of V into V3, V4 in such a way that V3 union V4 is a vertex set of graph G, that is V, and their intersection is an empty set. Okay, now what we are doing is we are taking V5 and V6 new vertex set in such a way that V5 is V1 intersection V4 union with V2 intersection V3. And we are taking V6 as V1 intersection V3 union with V4 intersection V2. In fact, we can observe that this V5, which we are taking union of these intersections, they are nothing but ring sum of the vertex set V1 with the vertex set V3, and V6 is nothing but V2 ring sum V3. Okay, we can observe this with the example very easily. If you draw a graph, simple graph, then also you can understand this. So I'll explain that with an example later. First we'll prove the theorem. V5 is nothing but V1 ring sum V3 and V6 is nothing but V2 ring sum V3. Now what I'm doing is I'm considering a ring sum S1 with S2. I have taken two cut sets. I have to prove this ring sum is again a cut set or edge disjoint union of cut set. Now when I consider this ring sum, I can observe that edges belonging to this ring sum are the edges from the vertex set V5 to V6. Edges belonging to this ring sum are only from V5 to V6. Are only from V5 to V6, and also I can observe that this ring sum contains all the possible edges between V5 and V6, and also contains all the edges between V5 and V6. So what I can say, removal of this ring sum S1 ring sum S2 from graph G will disconnect the graph, and it will disconnect the vertex set into two vertex sets V5 and V6 in such a way that V5 union V6 is a vertex set V, and V5 intersection V6 is an empty set. Thus, I can say that S1 ring sum S2 is a cut set or an edge disjoint union of cut set. I can say removal of S1 ring sum S2 disconnects G. Disconnects G in such a way that it partitions the vertex set. Partitions the vertex set. Vertex set into V5 and V6 such that V5 union V6 is a vertex set of G, that is V, and V5 intersection V6 an empty set. Hence the proof, I can say S1 ring sum S2 is again a cut set or an edge disjoint union of cut set. I'll give you one small example. Suppose this is my graph, say like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C, D, E, F are the edges. Now I'll define one cut set, that is S1. So I'll write A and B as the edges, they form a cut set. So now the vertex set is partitioned into two sets, say V1 and V2. Now V1 is simply 2 and V2 is 1, 3, 4, 5. Similarly, I'll take one more cut set, that is S2, say A, E, D. Now this will form two vertex sets, that is V3 and V4. V3 is a singleton set which has an edge, vertex 1. V4 has 2, 3, 4, 5 as the vertices. Now we'll observe, I have considered V5 as V1 intersection V4 union with V2 intersection V3, right? So now this is V1 intersection V4 is a singleton set, it has vertex 2, and V2 intersection V3 has only 1. So this set is 1, 2. Similarly, V6 is nothing but V1 intersection V3 union with V4 intersection V2. So this is nothing but, this is an empty set union with 3, 4, 5. So that V6 comes out to be 3, 4, 5. Now you can observe, I'll take up these two. Now vertex set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is partitioned into two sets. One is 1, 2, another is 3, 4, 5. 1, 2 and another is 3, 4, 5. 1, 2 and 3, 4, 5. Let me call this as say S3 is a partition which is giving me two set of vertex set, that is 1, 2. And another set is 3, 4, 5. In fact, I can observe this S3. See, this is the partition. Okay. I'm taking vertex set 1, 2. Another is 3, 4, 5. So I can observe that this S3 is nothing but ring sum of S1, S2. What is ring sum of S1, S2? In fact, S1 ring sum S2 is nothing but, I have to remove the common things, B, E, D, right? So 1, 2 in one hand and 3, 4, 5 in another set. So the partition is B, E, D, which is S3. So S3 is nothing but B, E, D, in fact, which is nothing but ring sum of S1, S2. Therefore, I can say ring sum of two cut set is again a cut set. See, this is again a cut set. You may come across with the things like the cut set which you are getting, which can be rewritten as union of disjoint cut sets. For that, as for the same graph, I'll take one more example. So for the same graph, okay, I've taken different cut set, that is S1 is ACE, which gives the partition V1, V2, and S2 gives the partition 1, 2 and 3, 4, 5. Okay, one is this, another one is this. Now I'm taking V5. We know V5 is V1 intersection V4 union with V2 intersection V3. So which gives me 1, 3, 5. Similarly, V6 is nothing but in V1 intersection V3 union with V4 intersection V2. So that gives me 2, 4. So I have got new partition, that is 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 5 and 2 and 4. Okay, so S3, I'm defining say some partition which gives me the partitions like this. 1, 3, 5 as one set and 2, 4 as another set. Say for this now, what is S1 ring sum S2? It is A C B D. In fact, A B C D. Okay. Now you may get the doubt that this is not a cut set, because we know cut set is a minimal set. It has to be a proper set. Removal of that gives me disconnected G. Right. Now this is not a minimal set. If I consider only AB, that will also disconnect the graph. That's why this can be rewritten as A, B union with C, D. Now this can be cut set, this is also cut set, this is also cut set. So now this new S3 is nothing but S1 ring sum S2. In fact, it is a edge disjoint union of cut set. In the previous example, you are directly getting a cut set. Okay, ring sum of two cut set is again a cut set. But in this example, you are getting ring sum of two cut set is an edge disjoint union of cut set. Next is fundamental cut set. Fundamental cut set is a cut set which has got exactly one branch of a spanning tree. And this is also called as basic cut set. Remember, with respect to spanning tree, we are defining a fundamental cut set, and it has got exactly one branch of a spanning tree. Suppose I have this as my graph. Okay. Now, the same example I'll take every time. A, B, C, D, E, and F. Okay. Now, if my spanning tree is defined like this, if I take this spanning tree, A, C, A, E, C, F, if I consider A, E, C, F as my spanning tree, I can define one such fundamental cut set which has got exactly one branch of a spanning tree. It's a cut set which has got only one branch of a spanning tree. So suppose this AB. This is a cut set which has got only one branch of a spanning tree. If I consider BDE, then that is also a fundamental cut set. BDE, which has got only one branch of a spanning tree. Next is a theorem. It says if I have a spanning tree, okay, with respect to particular branch of a spanning tree, I can define a fundamental cut set, and it is contained in, this branch is contained in every fundamental cycle which are associated with the chords in S. Okay, with respect to a given spanning tree T, a branch BI that determines fundamental cut set S, which is contained in every fundamental cycle associated with God in S, and it is not there in other fundamental circuits. So for that we'll take small example first, explain the example first, and then we'll prove the theorem. Suppose I have graph, say this is my graph A, B, C, D and E. This is my spanning tree. See, my spanning tree is A, B, D. Now, we know what is fundamental cut set. It's a cut set which has exactly one branch with respect to the spanning tree. And we know fundamental circuit is a circuit obtained by adding a chord to spanning tree. So let me take a fundamental cut set. One such cut set I'm considering, say B C E. Okay, B C E is a fundamental cut set because it has got only one branch of a spanning tree. So B C E is my fundamental cut set. Okay, what I have to prove is this B, this branch occurs in all the fundamental circuits which are associated with the chords in S, and this does not occur in any other fundamental circuit. Okay, so I'll write the fundamental circuits which are the possible fundamental circuits, fundamental cycles. I'll write this is obtained by adding a chord to spanning tree. Okay, for this spanning tree, if I add this chord C, then I'm going to get one fundamental circuit. I'm calling it as gamma 1, that is A, B, C. I have added the chord C. Here, B is the branch. Next, these two are the chords. Next, I'll get one more fundamental circuit, that is by adding one more chord to a spanning tree, that is E. So that A, B, D, E is my fundamental circuit. Is there any possible fundamental circuits? No more, right? Now you can observe that these are the fundamental circuits which are with respect to the chords C and E. And this branch B of a fundamental cut set occurs in every fundamental circuits which are associated with the chords in S. That is what we have to prove. This we have seen by the example. Now we will prove theoretically. Okay. Now let me consider a fundamental cut set, say S. S is a fundamental cut set determined by a branch, say determined by a branch, say BI. Branch BI. How is any fundamental cut set? This has got branch BI and rest are all the chords, right? C1, C2, like that, say some P chords are there. This is my fundamental cut set. Now I'll define a fundamental circuit, say gamma 1 is a fundamental circuit or fundamental cycle determined by a chord, say C1. Okay, now how is this? This is fundamental cycle obtained by adding chord to a spanning tree. So this C1 chord is added to a spanning tree. How are the edges of spanning tree? They are nothing but the branches, say B1, B2, like that, say some BN are there, suppose. Okay, they are the branches of the spanning tree. By adding chord C1 to the spanning tree, I am getting a circuit, fundamental circuit, that is gamma 1. Now you can observe that gamma 1 and S They have C1 as common, chord C1 as common. We know by definition, for cut set and a circuit, they share even number of edges in common. Since number of edges common to S and gamma 1 must be even by definition, therefore this BI must be there one among this. Okay, therefore BI must be in gamma 1, BI must be in gamma 1. Why? We know number of, because we know number of edges in common to S and gamma 1 is even. This is with respect to, we know number of edges in common to fundamental circuit and cut set is always even. Therefore, already C1 is there. So, this BI must be there in gamma 1. Same is true for all those fundamental circuits which are made by the chords C2, C3, C4 up to C5. Okay. Same thing is true for all the fundamental circuits which are formed by C1, C2, C3 up to CP. Okay, they share even number of edges in common with S. Suppose I have one more fundamental circuit, that is gamma P plus 1. Okay, in that BI is there. Okay, suppose BI is contained in the fundamental cut set gamma P plus 1. It's now this gamma P plus 1 has no chords of this C1, C2, CP. Right? See, gamma 1 had C1 with the branches. Okay. So, the among this one is BI. Any one is BI. Okay, so they have common. Now similarly, gamma 2 is a fundamental circuit obtained by using chord C2. Now B1, Bn. So one among this is BI. It has to be. So even number of edges in common to S. Similarly, gamma 3 like that I'll get. Okay, gamma P. Now I'm considering gamma P plus 1. Okay, this is obtained by chord CP plus 1. Okay, and it has got one such BI. Suppose one BI is there. Now, what are the number of edges in common to S? S has got BI C1, C2 up to CP. CP chords they have got. Now I am taking one more fundamental circuit which is obtained by the chord CP plus 1. Therefore, what you can say, there is only one edge in common with with this CP plus 1 and S, which is not so, which should not be, because we know if I consider any circuit and a cut set, they share even number of edges. Therefore, there is no such gamma P plus 1 which has got BI in it. Hence, with respect to a given spanning tree, a branch BI that determines a fundamental cut set S, which is there in every fundamental cut set, which is there in every fundamental circuit associated with S, but it is not there in any other fundamental circuits. Any other fundamental circuits. That's what I have proved. I have proved that BI, branch BI, is there in all the fundamental cut sets. Gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma P, up to gamma P. If I consider it is there in other gamma P plus 1, then I'll get a contradiction to the fact that they share even number of edges. Therefore, it cannot be there in any other fundamental cut set. Hence the proof. Similar to this theorem, we can prove one more theorem, that is, with respect to given spanning tree, a chord Ci that determines a fundamental cycle gamma, which occurs in every fundamental cut set associated with branches in gamma and in no other. There, what we have proved with respect to a spanning tree only, but we are taking a branch, we are taking a cut set with that branch, and that branch occurs in all the fundamental circuits and it is not occurring in any other. Okay, here what we are doing is we are taking a chord and we are taking a fundamental cycle. Okay, so I'll give you an example for this. I'm not going to prove, but just I'll give you an example to explain this. Suppose this is my graph, say A, B, C, D and E. This is a spanning tree. See, spanning tree is A, B and D. Now I'll define a fundamental circuit, that is gamma, which is A, B and C. Fundamental circuit is obtained by adding a chord to a spanning tree. So C is my chord. Now I'll write all possible cut sets now. Cut set S1 say is B, C and E. Cut set S2 is A, C, E. And I'll write one more cut set say D, E. Now you can observe by the theorem I have to prove that chord Ci which determines a fundamental circuit occurs in every fundamental cut set. This chord C is occurring in all the fundamental cut sets. I have to check. See, this BC is a fundamental cut set. BC is a fundamental cut set which has got exactly one branch, that is B. Okay. Similarly, so C is there in this. Chord C is there in this fundamental cut set. S2 is another cut set, ACE. Exactly one branch of spanning tree is there. Therefore, it is a fundamental cut set. One branch. Now, this C is there in this. So, chord is there in these two fundamental cut set. When I come to this, DE, this is a fundamental cut set. But this is not having the chord C. Okay. That's what I'm saying. The chord Ci which occurs in all the fundamental cut sets associated with the branches of fundamental cycle. See, these fundamental cut sets are associated with branches A and B, means branches of gamma. So this occurs in only those fundamental cut sets which are associated with the branches of gamma.